there. Welcome to episode 10 of Knit Talk with a Tech Editor. I'm Megan of the Unapologetic Knitter, and I'm a tech editor. We're going to start this new Sunday special series, and they are going to be shorter episodes covering topics that will be relevant to things that were learned earlier in the week in our regular Wednesday podcasts. And today, we're going to do a quick walkthrough of how to do yardage estimates for modifications that you want to make to a project, whether that's adding either length or circumference, no, adding length or subtracting length. So let's start with the really obvious concept. If the modifications that you are looking to make are fairly basic and are in the vein of removing, so perhaps you're knitting a sleeve a little bit shorter or a body a little bit shorter, you can still use the yardage that is listed for your size in the pattern, and you'll just have a little bit more overage than you might have otherwise had if you were knitting the full-size garment. Consider it a bonus for making a larger swatch. But if you're making a significant change, either removing sleeves, like turning a drop shoulder style sweater into a vest, or if you're adding length to a garment, you need to be able to estimate the yardage you need above and beyond or significantly less than what the pattern calls for. I hope that makes sense. If you're removing sleeves, basically you don't want to be buying all of the yardage you need to make full-size sleeves if you're not going to knit them anyway. That would be way more yarn that you need. Of course, if you're adding length, you want to make sure you've got enough on hand to make those modifications so you don't have to deal with different dye lots. So, I know a lot of us don't really love to swatch. We love to jump right into our project. But when you're considering making modifications, especially for a garment, your swatch is going to be your biggest friend. So, to walk through today's processes or to start doing this on your own, there are five things that you're going to need, maybe four, depending on what modifications you're looking to make. So the first thing you're going to need is a swatch, and if you're making a garment, I really recommend making a nice big swatch. You're going to need a scale. I've got this cute little scale that I got on Amazon, and I will add a link to this in the description below the video. It's like $11. And it goes to a tenth of a gram. It's really wonderful. You'll need a calculator. You can use your cell phone for that. And a ruler or measuring tape. And if you're making modifications where you're adding length to a sleeve, you may want to have the schematic on hand just so you know what your top of sleeve circumference and the bottom sleeve circumference is from the original design, so you can then add that length using the same shaping. So the first thing you're going to want to do with your swatch is lay it flat on a non-stick surface. I mean, any tabletop or countertop will do. Just don't put it on like carpet or a blanket or something where it might hold the dimensions of your swatch at the wrong shape. And you're physically going to measure the dimensions of your swatch. So this swatch that I've got here using as an example is 7.5 inches wide by 7 inches tall. So now you're going to use those two numbers, the width by the height, and convert it into a square area. I'm going to have an example up on the screen in just a moment, but I just want to walk through the steps before we get to that. So once you've measured your swatch and found the square area, now you're going to weigh your swatch, and that's where the little kitchen scale comes in really handy. Something digital is really precise, which I really like, especially if you're going to be doing like really large modifications where you don't want to be making generalizations about how much extra yardage you need. So you're going to weigh your swatch. I strongly recommend it doing this in grams. They are just a little bit more precise than if you tried to work in decimals of ounces, but the choice is up to you. And then the final step is applying all of those numbers to figuring out your how many grams you need to knit a square inch. Here's how the math breaks down. So I measured my swatch. It's 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters wide by 7 inches or roughly 18 centimeters tall. I'll have the exact numbers up on the screen because this is not a place for rounding. You want specific numbers. And so that means that the 7.5 by 7 is 52.5 square inches, or in centimeters, that's 338.7 centimeters. When I weighed my swatch, it is 16.1 grams, and that's where the kitchen scale with the decimal in grams comes in really helpful. Again, it saves on rounding. So to apply that 16.1 grams to the square area of our swatch, we're going to divide the weight by the total square area to find out how many grams we need for one square inch of our project, whether you're adding or subtracting. So we will take our 16.1 grams, this is for the US units, and divide it by 52.5 because that's the square area of our swatch, and we get roughly 0.3 grams of yarn per square inch. We're gonna do the same thing if we're working in metric. We're gonna take our 16.1 grams and divide it by our 338.7 square centimeters, and we get a result of roughly 0.47 grams per square centimeter of work. So we're gonna apply this information to a really simple example. Let's imagine that we're knitting a sweater that is 40 inches in circumference, or 101.6 centimeters around, and we want to add 4 inches to the length of the garment, or 20.5 centimeters. We're going to multiply those two numbers, the circumference, 40 inches, by the depth that we want to add, 4 inches, and we get 160 square inches. If we were doing this in centimeters, we would multiply our 101.6 centimeters by the length that we want to add, which is 10.16 centimeters with absolutely no rounding, and we get an area of 132.25 square centimeters. That is the area of the modification that we're looking to make. It's how much more we're going to be adding to the garment. So we're going to take that square area that we need to add, 160 inches, or 132.25 square centimeters, and multiply it by the number that we got in our grams per square inch, or grams per square centimeter. Again, this will be up on the screen, but essentially you're going to be taking the 160 square centimeters and multiplying it by the 0.3 grams per square inch, and we get a result of 49 and a decimal. That's how many additional grams of yarn you need to make the modification. We do the same exact thing with the centimeters using those numbers. You'll have your 1,032.25 square centimeters that you want to add to the project, and you're going to multiply it by the decimal that you had of your grams per square centimeter, which was roughly 0.047 grams per square centimeter. And again, we get a decimal, or a number of 49.03. So whether you do it in metric or whether you do it in US units, what we're finding out is based on our gauge and our yarn usage, we need 49 extra grams of yarn to make that modification. So what you're going to do is now take that 49 grams and add it to what the pattern already calls for so that you can buy the additional yarn all at the same time with your project to make sure you don't run out. If you were working in reverse and you were perhaps omitting the sleeves, going back to the example I used earlier, you will simply find the square area of your sleeves, multiply the amount of grams you need per square inch or per square centimeter, and subtract it from your total amount. And that's it. That's as simple as it gets. So just remember that when it comes to estimating yardage for your modifications, your swatch is your most powerful tool, because you want to make sure that you buy the additional yardage that you need before you start the project. So coming up this coming Wednesday, May 17th, I'm going to have a new technique tutorial that talks about, or actually demonstrates, the physical method of picking up and knitting stitches along the edge of your work using the golden ratio method that we talked about in episode 8. Since we talk about sweater modifications so much, I just want to remind you, or let people know who have found me for the first time today, about my free guide to knitting your first sweater, you can go to unapologeticknitter.com/MFS, as in my first sweater, download that free guide, and get knitting your very first sweater. If you found value in today's episode or any of my episodes, I would love you to like this video, or love for you, I would love you anyway, but love for you to like this video and subscribe to my channel. It tells the YouTube algorithms that I'm doing a good job, and it helps us refer these videos to other knitters when they come to YouTube. Thank you so much for being here today. I hope you enjoyed this little quick and dirty tutorial about yardage estimates. I look forward to seeing you next time, and happy knitting!